Nearly a week after Pakistan reported that an Indian supersonic flying object landed in the Pakistani city of Mianchanu, Indian Defence Minister Rajnath Singh has responded to the incident, saying that while India deeply regretted the misfiring, the country's missile system is very reliable and safe. Making a statement in the Rajya Sabha on Tuesday morning, Singh said, "During routine maintenance and inspection, a missile was accidentally released at around 7 p.m. It was later learned that the missile had landed inside the territory of Pakistan. While this incident is regretted, we are relieved that nobody was hurt due to the accident. I would also like to state that a review of the standard operating procedures for operations, maintenance and inspections is being conducted in the wake of this incident. We attach the highest priority to the safety and security of our weapon systems. If any shortcoming is found, the same would be immediately rectified," he said. Shortly after the Karnataka High Court on Tuesday announced the state government order on restrictions on wearing of hijabs in schools and colleges won't be cancelled, Anas Tanveer, a Supreme Court lawyer, tweeted that students in Udupi College will approach the Supreme Court. "Met my clients in hijab matter in Udupi, moving to SC soon, inshallah. These girls will continue their education while exercising their rights to wear hijab. These girls have not lost hope in courts and constitution," his tweet read. An India Today report said that Prime Minister Narendra Modi had recommended the movie The Kashmir Files to BJP members of parliament. At the parliamentary party meeting on Tuesday, the Prime Minister had said that "The Kashmir Files is a very good movie, all of you should watch it. More such movies should be made." The Kashmir Files, directed by Vivek Agnihotri, released on March 11, 2022. The film is based on the exodus of Kashmiri Hindus from the valley in the 1990s. A sewage network that monitors for COVID-19 trends is warning that cases are once again on the rise in many parts of the United States. The data from Centers for Disease Control and Prevention was analyzed and reported by Bloomberg. More than a third of the CDC's wastewater sample sites across the U.S. showed rising COVID-19 trends in the period ending March 1 to March 10th. However, reported cases of COVID infections in the country remain low. It's not clear how many new infections the signs in the sewage represent. It can't be used to predict whether this will trigger a new wave of COVID-19 or only indicate a slight bump in cases as the pandemic slowly ends. However, the data has sent alarm bells ringing on the possibility of a surge in cases as COVID restrictions are diluted and many are returning back to working from offices after a two-year gap. E-commerce giant Amazon on Tuesday put out a public notice in a newspaper accusing Future Retail and its promoters of committing fraud after Reliance Industries took over some retail stores of FRL. Amazon is fighting a legal battle with FRL to stop the Kishore Biyani-led retailer's $3.4 billion deal with Reliance Industries Limited. In October 2020, Amazon sent legal notice to Future for the deal. It alleged it breached Future's agreement with Amazon.